Rolling and go for it.
There's one application that everybody on the planet needs, and it's this right now. Let's do that again. You open the door.
Good time.
I open the door.
Great fucking time.
Great fucking time.
We already went through a lot.
Wait.
You did your opening pitch?
Oh, yeah.
So the thing for the what?
I talked about saving the rainforest because you weren't here to give me direction, and I talked about how important it was. I sat next to a rocket. Yeah, I absolutely slated it, spelled it. I actually sat next to a rocket scientist, and he described how the planet is dying. This is how important that not only the Veritas rainforest, but all rainforests on the planet. And I said, it's an upward spike every single year.
And where's your JPL and NASA?
Yeah, JPL. And then what I was going to do is JPL. Yeah. And what I was going to say is, I want to get this application into everybody's fucking.
What's it called?
Earth Now.
Earth Now in 3D. Exactly. It's a theater near you.
Exactly. And so what we're going to do is we can show the vital signs, and we can go to carbon dioxide.
Yeah, how are we doing?
Say that. We suck. We're fucking dying.
Hold it. You can't say the F word. There may be Disney kids on the
Well, actually, can I swear?
No.
Okay.
No, don't swear.
You see that?
I mean, just because the Catholic Church started doesn't mean you have to continue it.
It's a real-time 3D
model. Wow. Yeah. That's the real pollution right now?
Yeah.
Oh, that's
carbon dioxide.
Okay.
Yeah.
So now, how's the air level? Clear air. That's carbon.
Mm-hmm.
What's the air footprint?
Okay, so
is
the
air,
60? Well,
air temperature. Let's
air temperature.
Yeah, let's get to the record temperatures here. Hold it.
Here we go. Air this temperature running one. There we go.
What?
Yeah.
It's almost all red.
Yeah.
Hold it. Turn this way. Yeah. Can you see that?
I see it very well.
Whoa.
Yeah.
All
red. Yeah.
Oh, look at it. It's raising. It literally. I'm seeing it literally slowly creeping.
Yeah. It is.
It's totally almost covered. The planet is turning red, folks. We are dying. That's what a heart looks like when it's beating. When this stops beating, we look like Mars.
Absolutely.
So we've been told by the UN not to use the footage that we originally were granted the interview.
But this is an app that everybody can use.
Whether we can use that footage or not, we're still talking with people. Whether we go, somebody's in my ear screaming, "Hi, Robert," while we're taping on set right now.
Hi, Robert.
Guess who it is?
I don't know.
Is our associate producer on the other side of the country?
Deanna.
Yes.
Hi, Deanna.
Who said that you said I'm throwing a big party at the end of this film so everybody can meet her.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
Oh, thanks.
That's exactly
And what you're paying for it. I think that's so generous.
Thank
you, Robert, for throwing that
never
big
said that.
Party for us.
He said words
party,
into
right?
my
big
mouth.
Party.
He's really good at that. He pushes people
so
in the
anyway,
too.
Yes, I do. At the ride, if you want to go swim in the current, it'll either be breaking your bones on the beach in Malibu. I don't suggest beginners or those slightly intoxicated to come anywhere near this course. Or you can come with Robert and I and watch him do his backward swan dive into the Tropicana pool bar.
Mm-hmm. At this time at Kirk Kelly's expense.
Yes, it did. It cost me a $600 cell phone and bar tab and...
New clothes?
Nah, didn't get that clothes.
Didn't get clothes. But then the budget of the film, he gets recycled rainforest clothes.
What else does that thing do?
Okay, well, let's see. We've got vital signs. We've got carbon monoxide.
Yeah.
These are the carbon monoxide.
Yeah, I don't like breathing that carbon monoxide thing. Yeah.
And as you can look at that.
Hold on, which continent is this? That's North America?
Yes.
That's Africa?
That's Africa.
Wow, Africa is almost blanketed.
North America.
Look at the carbon in the Middle East because of all of the refineries and... fossil fuels that we're using today instead of riding our bikes to the south like Ed Begley Jr. did.
Or just letting Tesla.
I know how far he lives from here. That's a hike. Or Tesla.
Or Tesla. Get a freaking electric car, people. I mean,
or at least get a hybrid. And, I haven't gotten an electric yet. I got a hybrid years ago. Mm-hmm. And I would rather get as many miles to a gallon not polluting the air so I can still breathe because I have enough trouble breathing.
I noticed that.
Ribs, yeah. So, what other features does this
have? Okay, so we've got everything from air temperature, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, gravity field, ozone, which we've started to fix, sea level.
It's rising, by the way.
Sea level is rising, and if you look at the red.
There. Wow.
Yes,
big.
Yes.
Okay, goodbye, south portion of the United States.
Yeah, this is really crazy.
So this is real stuff, folks, and this is a real film. This is not scripted. And we're not here on somebody's agenda except ours to say it's time for us collectively to stop polluting, to stop wasting, to stop abusing. Only humans kill out of greed, out of fear, out of anger, out of trophies. I've never heard of a lion killing a human and taking it home to make a rug for a trophy.
But they should start.
But they should start.
Because
they might live longer. Because the black jaguars, there's only 600 left.
They should start with a certain dentist in an old alley.
Yeah, yeah, that guy.
I don't think anybody's ever going to know.
Yeah, I think you. So my point is, it's not a joke. We've been told by very high level officials not to let you know that there's 5 to 10 years left on planet Earth if we continue our reckless path blazing through the planet. And there's 2 more degrees Celsius. I have a feeling this summer, being the hottest on record, we got at least a half a point, if not a full point, to that 2 point Celsius that I was told about before that record report just came out. So I have a feeling we're a lot closer than they're even telling me. But regardless of what I may or may not know, it's time for you to start digging in some research and stop reading the comics and the funny pages and your Facebook for a minute and start to do some research and find out, is planet Earth in need of your help? Or better yet, do you need to help planet Earth to save your own self? Please join us. We're at this film. We're at this rainforest. Should not die.
Very good.
Thank you. Okay, now we'll do the question. No, I don't. But I wasn't going to stop in the middle.
Can you do that one more time?
Yeah, can you pull it out of your pocket so we actually have it coming?
Yeah,
you know.
Exactly. I'm going to step out. We're going to step out for a second. Do cutaways on all the features so we have them. I'll be back in about 2-3 minutes.
Perfect.
So
sounds good.
Perfect. Sorry about that.
All right, ready?
Yeah, then, yeah, lead into it. So, hey, I got this app.
Okay, so here we go. I'm on focus. Good. And how about here? Is that good?
Yeah, that's actually great. Right there.
Okay, so I've got it. Okay, so perfect. Ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
You rolling?
Yep.
I've got this app that I think everybody on the planet should have. It's called NASA's Earth Now. And this was designed by the rocket scientist that I sat next to on the plane flight back from Seattle to Burbank. This thing has so many features, but if we can get this into the hands of at least half the population, well, half the population would know that we're kind of screwed. The vital signs that it has are everything from air temperature, and we'll wait till that loads. It loads pretty quick. It looks kind of hot, doesn't it? And it's just getting hotter. Other vital signs, carbon dioxide, all around the planet. Everything's monitored. Everything's connected. Carbon monoxide, wow. Planet Earth and industry and planet Earth sometimes just don't look like they get along very well. But there has to be a balance. There has to be a way that we can. The other interesting features on this app is that air temperature, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, gravity field, ozone, sea level. Another thing that's a little scary. Look at that. Rising. But as I described before.
Explain the colors.
Well, the colors are millimeters. The red, it goes from -176 to 176 millimeters and above. And where you see red, it's where everything is starting to rise at a dramatic rate. And in many years, I mean, there won't be a Leaning Tower of Pisa. There won't be, you know, a California coast. And with the glaciers melting, you know, the rainforest helps with a little bit of the carbon dioxide. But as I talked about before, it's just not enough. Every single year, it's going up. Here's the carbon dioxide, and then the plumes go down, and then up and down. They never just go up and then stay down. They just keep going up. And that's because of our industry, that's because of the practices that we use in these industries, and our sustainability. We don't approach anything with sustainability, and we really need to, because it's like a wake-up call for the planet. Wake up! I mean, we have to police ourselves. Nobody else is gonna do it, and eventually, we're just not gonna have enough people left to police ourselves. Don't think about yourself. Don't just think about yourselves, because that's what we do most of the time. Think about your children, think about your children's children, and then think about their children, because those are the people that aren't going to have a future. Those are the people that will have no hope. Like I said, we're going to have some futuristic forlorn society in some wasteland that looks like Dune, Or we have to go, like Interstellar, the movie, and find another planet to screw up. And it's just simply not acceptable. It's not going to be in my lifetime. I'll still probably live comfortably, and you know, that's a great thing. My daughter, my grandchildren, my great-grandchildren, it's not looking good, folks, and we really need to change. I implore you, save the planet. See, it's not like save the cheerleaders, save the world, but really it is, get the app, learn how to save the world. You can learn more about the Jet Propulsion Lab at their site, and I don't know what the hell that is, so I'll check it out in a second.
Isn't it JPL.org?
I think it is. I'm going to go check. I think it's JPL.org. I'm going to double check, though. I'm going to just go down here. It's, it was just like, oh my God, to see that, though. Okay. JPL.NASA.gov. Okay. Okay.
All right, pick up.
Okay, ready?
Yep.
So let me just do this one more time. Let me delete there, close that sucker out. Now bring it up one more time. Okay. And here we go. There was a show called Heroes. They canceled it. Ironically enough, they're bringing it back on the air. And I'm pretty excited. It kind of embodied that every one of us is unique, and we all have these special powers. And, well, at least the special ones. And, oh, let me try that again. Oh, sorry. September is an interesting month. They're bringing back a show called Heroes, which was canceled, and the people were just outraged. I, myself, was one of them. I really liked it. And they brought it back, and Heroes just talked about these unique people in the world that had these special abilities and made these changes. Well, you know, we can all be heroes, and we can all make change. Get the app, Earth Now, NASA's Earth Now, at jpl.nasa.gov. That's jpl.nasa.gov. Become a hero today and be like Charlie Sheen. Wow, we'll be winning. Duh. There we go. Cool. I don't know what the hell else if you want something to say. I'll take a break and we'll figure something out.
Okay.
So, like, dude, those oinks.
The thing is.